So welcome everyone, welcome to Sadhava classes. Today we are going to take third chapter, third lesson of your history textbook. The name of the chapter is Maratha Sardars, the famous house of the Bhosle, famous house of the Bhosles. Let's see, period of unrest. As the saints preached devotion to God, the brave Maratha Sardars started a tradition of bravery. This was a period of great unrest. The two sultans, the Adil Shah of Bijapur and Nizam Shah of Ahmednagar, were constantly at war with each other. They made use of armies of Maratha Sardars in this wars. The brave Maratha Sardars. The Marathas were both brave and tough. They were also fearless and loyal to their masters. They were very proud of their achievements on the battlefield. The brave Maratha soldiers, with a spear in hand and sword at the side, would ride in the Sardars' cavalry. All the Maratha Sardars had their own private armies. If such a Sardar went to Sultan with his army, the Sultan gave him employment, made a Sardar of his kingdom, and sometimes conferred a jagir upon him. The Sardars who received such a jagir considered himself a Raja. Okay, he was considered as a Raja. Then there were many famous Maratha Sardars at the court of Ahmednagar and Bijapur. The more famous among them, kon famous hota, who were the famous at that time? The Jadavs of Sindakhed, Nimbalkars of Fultan, Ghorpades of Mudhol, Mores of Jawadi, and Bhosles of Veru. Then, the Sindakhed Jadavs were descendants of the Yadavs of Devgiri. Jizabai, the mother of Shivaji Maharaj, was the daughter of Lakhuji Rao Jadav of Sindakhed. Then, tradition of valor. All these Sardars were brave, but many of them were sworn enemies of one another. They never thought that they should unite and do something for their own people. So, all their valor and bravery served the interest of others. Even so, they kept alive the warlike spirit, especially among the young. Many famous soldiers were born in the families who kept alive their tradition of valor. Among the famous families, Bhosles of Veru showed the great bravery and enterprise. Let's see about the Bhosle family. The temple of Ghrushneshwar. It was about 400 years ago. The temple of Ghrushneshwar near the Veru caves was falling to pieces. The walls had developed cracks, and the priest also had deserted the temple. Wo bhi wahan se chala gaya tha. Thus, the temple which was built in the honor of a great god was totally neglected. All the devotees who came there mourned over the sorry state of the temple, but no one thought of repairing. Kisne bhi usko repair karne ke, no one had thought of repairing it. Then a great devotee of Shiva visited the temple regularly. He would put flowers and bell on the lingam and express his innermost thoughts to the god. He carried out extensive repairs to the temple and restored it to the original condition. He also made arrangements for the proper maintenance of the temple. Now there were lights both inside and outside the temple, and the most grandeur of the Ghrushneshwar was restored. Who was this devotee and who did this? That he was the Maloji Raje Bhosle. Okay, kon hota the Maloji Raje Bhosle? He was Maloji Raje Bhosle. You are given a picture of Shahaji Raje. Then the Bhosles of Veru. Maloji Raje Bhosle and the Patil of Veru was a great devotee of Shiva. Babaji Raje had two sons, Maloji Raje elder and the Vithoji Raje younger, and Vithoji Raje the younger. Babaji Raje Bhosle had the rights of Patil in the Veru village. Maloji Raje and Vithoji Raje were both brave and enterprising. They had in their service many armed Maratha troops. It was a period of great unrest. The Mughal emperor from Delhi had attacked the kingdom of Nizam Shah. Daulatabad was then the capital of Nizam Shah. Malik Ambar was his wazir or chief minister at that time. Malik Ambar was able and wise. The two capable and brave brothers, who Shahji and Sharif Ji from Verus, soon caught his attention. On his recommendation, the Shah, that Nizam Shah, conferred on the Maloji Raja the Jagir of Pune and, sorry, two brothers were the Maloji Raja and Vithoji Raja, right? Sorry, I made a mistake. Then, Supe Paragnas, okay, he gave the Jagir, Pune and Supe Paragnas. So, the Bhosle became rich and powerful. Maloji Raja's wife was Umma Bai. She came from the house of Nimbalkars of Fultan. They had two sons, Shahji and Sharif Ji. Maloji Raja was killed in a battle of Indapur. At that time, Shahji was only 5 years old. Then Vithoji Raja looked after the children and the Jagir. Later, he asked in marriage of Shahji, the daughter of Lakujirao Jadhav. Jizabai, the daughter of Lakujirao, was well favored by the gods. Lakujirao accepted Vithoji Raja's proposal. And Lakujirao was a brave and valiant sardar in the court of Nizam Shah. He kept a large army of his own. He commanded great respect and honor. At the court of Nizam Shah, he celebrated the wedding of Shahji Raja and Jizabai with great pomp. Jizabai became the fortune of the Bhosle family. Jizabai kuthe aale aata Bhosle family madhe aale. Then Shahji Raja, Nizam Shah transferred to Shahji Raja the Jagir had conferred on Maloji Raja. Maloji Raja Jagir tene kunal dili Shahji Raja na tacha mulan. Shahji Raja was a brave and capable man in the respect held man held in great respect at the court of Nizam Shah. The Mughal emperor decided to conquer the kingdom of Nizam Shah. For this, he made an alliance with Adi Shah of Vijapur. Malik Ambar and Shahji Raja fought bravely to save Nizam Shahi. They defeated both the armies. His battle took place at Bhatwadi near Ahmednagar. Sharif Ji was killed in the battle. Shahji Raja displayed a great valor. He was praised everywhere as a brave general. His reputation in the court was so enhanced that even Malik Ambar began to feel jealous of him. This gradually led to antagonism between them. As a result, what happened? Shahji Raja sodun gele Nizam Shahila. So he left Nizam Shahi and joined the court of Adi Shah at Bijapur. Adi Shah honored him with a title of Sar Lashkar, that is chief of army. Later, there were many developments in Nizam Shahi. The wazir Malik Ambar died. His scheming son Fateh Khan became the wazir of Nizam Shahi. During his period, the Nizam Shahi began to decline. At about the same time, there was a threat of Mughal aggression. So Nizam Shah's mother appealed to Shahji Raja to return the Nizam Shahi and save it. Therefore, what happened at last? Shahji Raja left Adi Shahi and returned to Nizam Shahi. Shahji Raja je gele hote sodun te punna Nizam Shahi madhe paratle. Okay, so this was the lesson about Verus, Bhosles of Veru. Some question answers. I'll give the answers orally. You write the answers. First one question: among the famous families, the Daijash of Veru, who were the Veru Bhosle? Answer is: Bhosles of Veru showed great bravery and enterprise. Babaji Raja Bhosle had two sons, Maloji and Vithoji. Daijash was a capable wazir. Who was the wazir of Nizam Shah? That is Malik Ambar. It was Malik Ambar. Write the relation. Maloji Raja and Vithoji Raja, they were brothers. Shahji Raja and Lakujirao Jadhav, they were son-in-law and father-in-law. Shahji Raja and Sharif Ji, they were brother. Babaji Raja and Vithoji Raja. Babaji Raja and Vithoji Raja were father and son, right? Yes. If I make some mistake, please confirm. Sindhkhed, Jadhav, Fultan, Nimbalkar, Zawli, More and Mudol Ghorpade. Who restored the temple of Krishneshwar? He was the Maloji Raja Bhosle. Which Jagir was bestowed upon Maloji Raja Pune and Supe? Who fought bravely to save Nizam Shahi, Malik Ambar and Malikamba and Shaji Raze. With what title did Nizam Adi Shah honored Shaji Raze Sarlashkar, that is Chief of Army? Why did Shaji Raze leave Adi Shahi? Here is the answer. This one. So Nizam Shahi's mother appealed to Shaji Raze to return to Nizam Shahi and save it. Therefore, he left Adi Shah and returned to Nizam Shah. Okay. So you got all the answers, right answers, and send your answers.